Hello friends, this is Subhash Jadhav. Let me welcome you all in the lecture series for Assistant Motor Vehicle Inspector Examination. Here we discuss probable objective type multiple choice questions. Today we are going to discuss about supercharging in IC engines. So let us start. And the first question is, the performance of an engine can be improved by, and the options are increasing speed of the engine, use of higher compression ratio, increasing charge density, and all of the above. First one is increasing speed of the engine. So when we increase the speed, what will basically happen? When we increase the speed, the number of power strokes are going to increase, per unit time is going to increase. And therefore, obviously, per unit time, the power is going to increase, and in other words, the performance is going to increase. Use of higher compression ratio. So here you can see this is a formula for efficiency of a auto cycle, where it is given by 1 minus something, and this particular something has the compression ratio in the denominator. And when we increase the compression ratio, means when we increase the denominator, this particular term is going to become smaller, and in other words, auto cycle efficiency is going to increase. Similarly, for diesel cycle efficiency also, it is like this, multiplied by something, obviously, where again the compression ratio is in the denominator. So we can say for engines, when the compression ratio is increased, the power output is going to increase, or the performance is going to improve. Third is increasing the charge density. So what happens when we increase the charge density? When we increase the charge density, the amount of air available inside the combustion chamber, or in other words, amount of oxygen available inside the combustion chamber is going to be more. And when we have more air inside the combustion chamber, we can burn more fuel. In other words, performance is going to increase. So the correct answer is A, all of the above. The purpose of supercharging is to, so here this is what supercharger looks like, something like this. Here we have a compressor, and air from the compressor is given to the engine intake manifold, and combustion takes place, and it is going to, the power output here coming from the engine is taken for the compressor. So here the question is, the purpose of the supercharging is to, options are A, increase the compression ratio, utilize exhaust gas energy, increase charge density, and increase speed of the engine. So first, increase the compression ratio. So here, engine compression ratio can be increased if you do something with the engine. We cannot increase the compression ratio by using an external compressor. So this is not the correct answer. Utilizes exhaust gas energy. So exhaust is coming from here, which is not being utilized in this particular case, because here this is the supercharger, and therefore second is also not correct answer. Increasing charge density. So you can see over here, air is taken by the compressor, it is densified over here, and it is supplied to the engine. So the correct answer is increasing the charge density. Increasing the speed of the engine is not the purpose of the supercharging. So the correct answer is C, increase the charge density. Supercharging is the process of, so here it is shown, and the options given are A, providing the forced cooling air, raising exhaust pressure, supplying air at a density greater than the density of the surrounding atmosphere, supplying compressed air to remove combustion products fully, providing the forced cooling air. Obviously, when here the air is taken, air is being densified over here, and it is supplied, but when we densify the air in the compressor, it is becoming hot. So providing a cooling air is not the purpose at all. Raising the exhaust pressure. So the, when the pressure is going to higher or smaller, it has nothing to do with the supercharger over here. So it is not the purpose of a supercharger. Supplying air at a density greater than the density of the surrounding atmosphere. When the air is taken here and it is densified and it is sent to the engine. So obviously the answer is supplying air at a density greater than the density of the surrounding atmosphere, and supplying compressed air to remove the combustion product fully. Here the compressed air is supplied obviously, but it is not with the purpose of removing the combustion product fully. So it is not to remove the combustion products. Fourth is also a wrong answer, and therefore the correct answer is C, supplying air at a density greater than the density of the surrounding atmosphere. Next is supercharged engines as compared to an ordinary engine, and the options are requires smaller foundation, is lighter, produces more power, and all of the above. Here already we have seen that this particular engine is supplied with the air which is compressed. That means we are burning, having more amount of air accommodated in the engine cylinder, the same engine cylinder, And burning more fuel and therefore producing more power. That means with respect to the increased power generated by the engine is going to be smaller, and therefore the foundation obviously will be required also will be smaller. This is going to be lighter. Obviously we have not used a bigger engine or a stronger engine. In the same engine we are doing all these things, and therefore the engine is going to be lighter, produces more power. Here you can see this is a naturally aspirated engine and this is a supercharged engines. Here this particular cycle is the power output coming from the engine, and this negative cycle is the power consumed for suction and exhaust. So the net power is going to be this A minus B, while here this particular cycle in case of a supercharged engine becomes a positive cycle because we are supplying compressed air to the engine. So therefore this also becomes positive. So the net power here becomes A plus B, and therefore the power is increasing. So produce more power is one of the purpose of the supercharging. That means the correct answer becomes all the above, that is D. Supercharging air compressor is driven by, so here we have a supercharger, and here the supercharger supplies air and the engine produces power, and from the crankshaft of the engine we are supplying power to the compressor. So exhaust gas turbine, so we are not using the turbine to supply the power to air compressor. Engine itself, so we are supplying the engine using the engine power for running the compressor. So both A and B, both cannot be the answers because this is wrong, and therefore the correct answer is B, engine itself. Different types of superchargers used are, so generally the different types of superchargers used in engines, it can be anything which can compress the air. Anything which can compress the air can be used because our main purpose in the supercharging is to densify the air and supply it to the engine. So it can be a roots type blower or a screw type or a vane type blower or a centrifugal type of a blower. So anything can be used. So vane type, roots type, centrifugal type, that means all can be used. So the correct answer becomes D, all of the above. Which of the following is a method of engine supercharging? So here the options are under piston supercharging, ram effect, both A and B, and none of the above. Under piston supercharging, here what we do in under piston supercharging, when we move the piston from BDC to TDC, there is a negative pressure created inside the crankcase of the engine, and this particular negative pressure can be utilized for sucking the air. Again, when the piston moves down, the same air is going to be compressed and it is going to be supplied to the engine combustion chamber. So under piston supercharging is a method of supercharging. What is this ram effect? So ram effect is basically nothing but utilizing the inertia of the gases which are flowing into the combustion chamber. So initially some amount of air is flowing, and whatever air is coming in the later stage is going to compress the air which is already present inside the combustion chamber. So this particular effect is called as ram effect. Obviously that is also happening inside the combustion chamber if the induction system is properly designed, and that can be utilized for supercharging. So A is also correct answer, B is also correct answer. So the correct answer becomes both A and B, that is C, option C. In turbocharging, compressor is driven by, so here it is what is shown as a turbocharger. Here we have a compressor where air is taken in, air is compressed and it is supplied to the engine cylinder. It is the combustion products are produced over here. The exhaust gases are going to what we call as a turbine over here. They are going to impact on the turbine blades and the turbine is going to rotate. Whatever energy is being produced over here through this particular shaft, it is given to run the compressor. So what we are using here, the question is who is driving the turbocharger. So this is a turbocharger over here, which is being compressor, which is driven by this particular turbine, and this totally we call it as a turbocharger. So here we have exhaust gas coming and it is driving this particular turbine, and turbine power is output is given to the compressor, which we call as a turbocharger. So engine directly is not running the turbocharger, separate electric motor we are not using. Here we can see on one side we have a compressor and other side we have a turbocharged blades, and such a mechanism is utilized over here to run the system. Answer is A, gas turbine. Which statement is true? All superchargers are turbochargers, all turbochargers are superchargers, both A and B are true, none of the above. All superchargers are turbochargers. So here we can see we are meaning that the every supercharger is a turbocharger. Obviously not, because turbochargers are run, utilizing the exhaust energy for running the compressor, while in the supercharger we utilize the engine power to run the compressor, and therefore this statement is not true. All turbochargers are superchargers. Obviously this is the correct answer, because in turbocharger we are using again a compressor. Either it is run by engine, or whether it is run by engine or by exhaust energy, it is immaterial. So the supercharger, that is all turbochargers are using a compressor which is run by some energy, and therefore it is a supercharger. So the correct answer is B, all turbochargers are superchargers. Thank you.